So today we start simultaneous linear equation. So find the x and y by substitution method. So first we understand what is simultaneous linear equation. So there is a linear equation. The general form is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, where a, b and c are numbers, maybe minus and plus, and x and y are the variables. So this is linear equation. A linear equation means the degree 1. So if I take example, so how to find the value of x and y if you have two linear equation? Suppose I take x plus y is equal to 7, and second one 3x minus 2y is equal to 11. So these are the two equation. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. You have to find the value of x and y by substitution method. You have three methods: substitution method, elimination by equating coefficient, and one graphically, and one more, that is cross multiplication method. The first we have just discussed substitution method. So this is the general form of linear equation, ax plus by plus c. So suppose there is two equation given, x plus y is equal to 7 and 3x minus 2y is equal to 11. So you have two equation, you have to find x and y by substitution method. So in substitution method, what do we use? We just form any, from any equation, we just find x in terms of y or y in terms of x. Okay, you can find x is equal to in terms of y, and you can do y is equal to in terms of x. So from this two equation, from first equation, I just use like this, that from first equation, from equation 1, x plus y is equal to 7. So x is equal to 7 minus y. So this is x in terms of y. Okay. So this is your equation number 3. Now just putting the value of x, putting the value of x in equation 2. Sir, why are you putting the value of equation, putting value of x in equation 2? Because we just find the value x in terms of y from equation 1. That's why you put in equation 2. Okay. So, putting the value of x in equation 2, equation 2 is 3x minus 2y is equal to 11. So, 3 in place of x, you write 7 minus y, minus 2y is equal to 11, 3, 7 is 21, minus 3y, minus 2y is equal to 11. So, 21 go this way, so minus 3 and minus 2 is minus 5y is equal to 11 minus 21, so minus 5y is equal to minus 10, so minus minus cancel, y is equal to 2. Okay, now this y is equal to 2, you have to find putting the value of y in equation 3, and you find x. So right here, from 3, x is equal to 7 minus y, so x is equal to 7 minus, value of y is 2. So, x is equal to 5. Therefore, x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 2. Like this, you solve the equation, find the value of x and y by using substitution method. Okay. One more question. 8x plus 5y is equal to 9 and 3x plus 2y is equal to 4. You have two equations. And you are using substitution method. So, from this two equation, you can take any one. So suppose I take from 1. So you write from equation 1. So what is equation 1? 8x plus 5y is equal to 9. Now it is depend upon you that what you do, what you find. If you write x in terms of y, or you can write y in terms of x. It is depend upon you. So suppose I take x in terms of y again, or you can take y in terms of x. So wait, 5y is equal to what? 9 minus 8x. So y is equal to what? 9 minus 8x by 5. So this is your equation 3. So this time I just change y in terms of x. Y is equal to in terms of x. Now putting the value of y. In equation what? Tell. Because I just find the value of y from equation 1, that's why I put the value of y in equation 2. So what is equation 2? 3x plus 2y is equal to 4. So 3x and 2, in place of y you put 9 minus 8x by 5 is equal to 4. So here 3x, 2 into 9, 18, 2 into 8, 16x by 5 is equal to 4. So here LCM is 5. So 5 into 3, 15x, and here 18 minus 16x is equal to 4. So plus 15 minus 16, that is your, here I do. Plus 15 minus 16, that is your minus x, plus 18, and this 5 into 4, this is 20. So minus x is equal to 20 minus 18, this 18 goes this way. So minus x is equal to 2, that means x is equal to minus 2. Okay. So your x is clear. Now you have to find y. So y from equation 3, from equation 3, y is equal to 9 minus 8x by 5, 9 minus 8 into x is minus 2 by 5, so this is 9 minus minus 16 by 5, so that is 9 plus 16 by 5, that is 25 by 5, cut 5. So that means value of x is minus 2 and y is plus 5. Okay, what do you do? From any equation 1 or 2, you can just find a value of x in terms of y or value of y in terms of x. That is your equation 3rd. Then you put the value of y in equation 2. Why? Because you find the value of y from equation 1. If you find the value of y from equation 2, then you just put the value of y in equation 1. Just opposite you do. Then you find the value of x, then just put in the value in equation 3. Clear? One another question. 2x minus 3y is equal to 7 and 5x plus y is equal to 9. So you can take any one equation. So this time I'll take equation 2. Okay. So I write from equation 2. 5x plus y is equal to 9. So here we just make y is equal to in terms of x, because y is alone, only y is given. So y is equal to, very simple, 9 minus 5x. This is your equation 3. If you find x is equal to, then it is little bit complicated, that 5x is equal to 9 minus y, then x is equal to 9 minus y by 5. It is little bit complicated. So why I take this complicated solution? Easy solution is there, y is equal to 9 minus 5x. That's why I will take y. Okay. Now, putting the value of y. Putting the value of y in equation 1. why I put the value of y in equation 1? Because from equation 2 I find the value of y. That's why I put in the value of y in equation 1. Clear? So equation 1 is what? 2x minus 3y is equal to 7. So 2x minus 3 in place of y you write 9 minus 5x is equal to 7. So here 2x, 3 9 ja 27 and minus minus plus 3 5 ja 15x is equal to 7. So plus 2x and plus 15x plus 17x and here 7 minus 27 go this way to plus 27. So 17x is equal to 34, x is equal to 2, 34 by 17 that is 2. So here you find the value of x that is 2. Again you write putting the value of x in equation 3, so you write from 3, y is equal to 9 minus 5x, so 9 minus 5 into value of x is 2. So 9 minus 10 is minus 1, so y is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to 2, therefore x is equal to 2, y is equal to minus 1. Okay, that is the value of x and y. Similar, same thing we do. You have two equations from any one, you just find the value of x or y. So here I find this one is easy, 5x plus y is equal to 9, that's why I'll take equation 2. So 5x plus y is equal to 9. So y is equal to this 5x go this way. So minus term. So then putting the value of y in equation 1. Why I put equation 1? Because I find the value of y from equation 2. Clear? Then find the value of x. And then putting the value of x in equation 3. We find the value of y. So this is substitution method. Okay. So one more question. Little bit complicated. So this is given in a fraction form. Okay, you have to change in a whole number. So here 7 and 3 is the LCM. So first you solve this one and make in a simplest form. And here also you make in a simplest form. So here 7, 3, LCM is 21. So here you multiply 3 whole, 2x plus 1. And again 7 multiply 5, 1 minus 3 is equal to 12. Okay, so this is 3, 2 ja 6x plus 3, 7, 5 ja 35y minus 21 by 21 is equal to 12. So 6x plus 35y, and plus 3 minus 21 minus 18 is equal to 21 into 12, you have to multiply. So 21 into 12, 2 into 2, 2 into 4, 1 and 2, so 2, 5, 2, so this is 252, so 6x plus 35y and minus 18 go this way, so plus, so this is 270, so this is your equation. 6x plus 35y is equal to 270. This is your equation 1. Now you have to change this one also. So 2 and 9 LCM 18. So 9 whole 3x plus 2 minus 9, that means 2 whole 4y plus 3 is equal to 13. So 9 into 3x, 27x, 9 into 2, 18, minus 2 into 4, 8y, and plus minus minus 6 is equal to 18 into 13. This one multiply. So here you have 27x minus 8y and minus plus 18 minus 6, that is plus 12 is equal to 18 into 13. 18 into 13, 234. 234. So this plus 12 go this way. So 27x minus 8y is equal to 234 minus 12, that is 222. So 27x minus 8y is equal to 222. Okay, so we have two equation, little bit lengthy and complicated, you can say, but you can solve easily. So these two equation. Now from equation 1 and from equation 2, we can change any one in terms of x and then just put the value of x in equation 2 or equation 1. Okay, so like this you have to solve. First, if it is any complicated equation in a fraction form, just make in a simpler equation like this and like this, then it is easy. Suppose you have two equation now, 6x plus 35y is equal to 270. So from here, if you find the x, so what happened? So 6x is equal to 270 minus 35y. So x is equal to 270 minus 35y by 6. This is your x. From equation 1 you find, and just putting the value of x in equation 2, from here you find the value of y. When you find the value of y, just putting the value of y in equation 3 here, then you find the value of x. It is a little bit lengthy because some big terms are there, 270, 35. So I have to multiply and find. The process is similar process. So this is substitution method. Okay. Then x by 6 plus y by 15 is equal to 4, and x by 3 minus y by 12 is equal to 4 whole 3 by 4. This is your equation 2. So you can change it, 4, 4 just 16, and 3, 19 by 4. 4, 4 just 16, and 3, 19 by 4. You can change it. Okay. Now, this is in a fraction form. So, if you want, you can change it into a simpler equation, simple linear equation. Or if you don't want, then no need. Just do like this. Suppose you can take from equation 2. From equation 2, x by 3 minus y by 12 is equal to 19 by 4. So x by 3 is equal to what? 19 by 4 plus y by 12. Okay. Clear? So x by 3 is equal to here 4 and 12, LCM 12. So here 3 into 19, 57, and here y. So x by 3 is equal to 57 plus y by 12. Okay. Now if you multiply it by 1 by 2, what happened? Here also multiply by 1 by 2, and here also multiply by 1 by 2. So here I multiply x by 3 into 1 by 2. So here also multiply 57 plus y by 12 into half. Sir, why you multiply? Sir, why you multiply with half? Because I want to make x by 6. That is, so in place of x by 6, I just put in the value. That's why I make x by 6. So here it is x by 6 is equal to how much? So 57 plus y, and here multiply, that means how much? 24. So my x by 6 is clear. This is my equation 3. Clear? Now putting the value of x by 6 in equation 1. So I write from equation 1. In place of x by 6, I put 57 plus y by 24 plus y by 15 is equal to 4. Here LCM is how much? LCM is 120. So 5 times, so 5 whole 57 plus y, and here plus 8 into 15, 820, so 8y is equal to 4. 5 into 57, how much? 285. Plus 5 into y, 5y. Plus 8y. By 120 into 4, here you write 480. Here you multiply. So 480. So 5y plus 8y, 13y is equal to 480, and this one go this time minus. So 13y is equal to 480 minus 285. How much? 480 minus 285. Here 15, 300. Go 5, 0, 0. Yes. Wait. 5, 19, 17, 9. And this one 3, 1, 195. So 195. So y is equal to what? 195 by 13, 13 1 ja, 6, 13 5 ja, so 15. So value of y is 15. Y is equal to 15. Now putting the value of y here, you can find the value of x. So from equation 3, x by 6 is equal to 57 plus y by 24. X by 6 is equal to 57 plus, in place of y we put 15, by 24. So x by 6 is equal to 57 and 24, how much? 57 and 10, 67, 72 by 24. So x is equal to 6 into 72 by 24, 24, 3 ja. So x is equal to 18. So therefore x is equal to 18 and y is equal to 15 is your answer. So like this, you use substitution method to find the value of x and y. Again, I tell you, what do you do? From any equation, you can find the value of x in terms of y, or value of y in terms of x, it depends upon you. My suggestion, just select that equation which is simplest form, maybe complicated, so we have to do with both the things, but if it is some simplest form, then use that equation, choose that equation first. So from this equation, you again find the value of x and y according to your choice. If you find x in terms of y, you can find y in terms of x. So from here you find the value of x or y. So that is your third equation. If you find the value of x or y from equation 2, then you put the value of x or y in equation 3. Just opposite, if you find the value of x and y from equation 1, then you put the value of x and y in equation 2, just opposite. Okay, so then from here you find the value of x, then put it into equation 3. So that equation 3, putting the value of x or y in equation 3, that is common. What is uncommon from this one? First, if you find from equation 1, again I tell, then you find the value, put the value of x in equation 2. That is common. Here I find the value of x from 2, that's why I find the value, putting the value in equation 1. That is the matter. So that's all, hope you understand. That is all for your simultaneous linear equation by substitution method. Clear?